The Forest Carbon Initiative was launched in 2017 as a way to use forest management to mitigate climate change.
This is a Forest Carbon Initiative tree planted in understory. This is a Douglas fir.
The Forest Carbon Initiative is a new approach to forestry. It's looking at our forests in terms of their ability to sequester carbon and also looking for ways to avoid the emissions from our activities in the forests.
Forest carbon cycle is the constant movement of carbon from the atmosphere into forested ecosystems, into harvested wood products, and then back into the atmosphere. So forest carbon modeling is then the science-based activity of tracking this movement of carbon. We use computer simulations to then simulate this transfer of carbon from the atmosphere into a forested ecosystem and then through wood products.
One of the benefits that I can point to that the forest carbon modeling has helped us with is doing forest management differently on rehabilitation of wildfire areas. So Elephant Hill was heavily hit, and we were looking for a way to make sure that our reforestation efforts really had a carbon benefit. And what the modeling showed us was that we were able to go in, not have to knock down the burnt trees, leave them as shade for those seedlings. So you sequestered the carbon with the standing carbon that was there with the burnt trees, but you also added carbon with the new seedlings going in and being underplanted in the same location. Without the modeling capability to challenge the analysis and different scenarios of forest management, we wouldn't have come to that conclusion necessarily.
The seed that we use for the Forest Carbon Initiative is really important. The trees that we select often come from a seed orchard or Class A seed. They're called that because they're genetically improved. They're not genetically modified, but they are selected so that they can absorb more carbon, they grow faster, and they're more resilient to both climate change and forest health.
So carbon sequestration is effectively the pulling of carbon dioxide out of the atmosphere and storage within forest biomass. Forests provide a unique opportunity in terms of climate change mitigation in the fact that trees naturally pull carbon dioxide out of the atmosphere. It's one of the only climate mitigation strategies that is a carbon sink of removing carbon from the atmosphere as opposed to avoiding emitting more back out into the atmosphere.
So forest carbon modeling and its success going forward links to a lot of the initiatives that government has underway. Things like Clean BC, things like the improvements to our Forest and Range Practices Act. Without the modeling, we have no way of knowing what we're achieving. And it will only get better based on the approaches that we're taking and the data that we're collecting and the refinements that we're doing to the ecosystems of models that we're using.